And joining us on the line now, Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia. Governor, good evening to you and thanks for joining us tonight.
Good evening, Carmina.
Right, DILG Secretary Marrojas calling it a lawful order. You, on the other hand, see it as politically motivated. Tell us again, why do you think this is so?
Pardon, I did not hear you.
Why?
Hello?
Yes, can you hear me now? Governor?
Yes,
can you hear me clearly?
Yes.
All right. So DILG Secretary Marrojas calling it a lawful order, but you, on the other hand, think it is politically motivated. He even said that, and I'm gonna paraphrase him now. Sabi po niya, kalokohan ang mga paratang na ito, walang kabuluhan, walang saysay. Mas lalo niyo daw pong binabaon ang sarili niyo sa mga violations na ito by defying the six-month suspension order. What do you say about that?
Well, he can say what he wants, and I think I am also entitled to the legal remedies that are available to me under our laws. I have pointed out that this case was filed a long time ago and was ended August 31st, 2011, under the Local Government Code, Section 66. The President had 30 days from end of investigation or until September 31st, 2011 to render a decision. However, this decision was only rendered ngayon lang, kahapon lang, December 17, 2012, exactly 474 days later. So this did not follow the lawful process. Mm-hmm. This is why I'm calling this order patently illegal. And further, this patently illegal order seeks to overturn the will of more than a million Cebuanos that voted me into office and re-elected me twice, giving me 3 terms to serve as their governor of Cebu. They wish now to overturn my mandate that I validly got from the Cebuanos by a very suspiciously timed suspension order lasting for 6 months, a most grievous penalty for a charge that does not even involve any illegal activity or an offense involving moral turpitude, or is there any accusation of malversation of public funds. The complaint of the then now deceased Vice Governor Sanchez sought to prove that I had in fact usurped his authority.
Mm-mm.
But if we talk of usurpation of authority, specifically referring to the budget of 2011, this was the case in point, that budget was approved by the provincial board. And I implemented that budget because this was properly covered with an appropriations ordinance.
Mm-hmm. So it's not as if...
It was a very flimsy charge.
So it's not as if you acted alone on this one. You had the whole council to back you up. You just implemented what their decision was.
That's right. And so I am saying that this is plain and simple, a power grab.
Mm.
Just because the vice governor that succeeded, the late Vice Governor Sanchez, belongs to the ruling party, the Liberal Party. So let us not hide behind all of these, nice words and etong mga empty and shallow reasons. Let's call a spade a spade.
Mm.
It's politics at its dirtiest at play here.
Governor, you mentioned a while ago that the Office of the President had until September 21st, 2011 to act on the complaint. Did you have any inkling that this was going to happen today?
Certainly not. Although when that suspension order was allegedly signed, I think they had the inkling. They had already leaked it to their people here, the Liberal Party members here. And so we were already alerted by their media yesterday morning.
Okay, now you still say that you are still the chief executive of Cebu. Now, how will you perform your duties despite the six-month suspension order?
Right now, Carmina, I am here at the Capitol in the governor's office earlier I met with all of our department heads. I issued an executive order to clarify that I shall continue to serve as governor of Cebu, being the duly elected governor of Cebu. And my instructions were to continue dispensation of services to our constituents. So it's business as usual here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I am seeking legal remedies that are available to me under the law, and we shall take that course.
Now, aren't you concerned, Governor Garcia, that as you defy the six-month suspension order, that you are, as Secretary Maro has said, you're burying yourself in one violation after the other? Aren't you concerned about how that's going to affect you and your bid come 2013?
You know, this has taught me, this present highly charged political atmosphere has taught me na, either you, whatever you do, if you do not belong to the ruling political party, you will always be vulnerable to any flimsy charge. And it's all up to them. So, sa akin lang, I will stand my ground here. I will show the people that elected me into office that I do not run away from their trust and confidence in me and the responsibility that I have in having been given this mandate.
Okay, let's look at the time left that you have. We have about 5 months to go before the midterm elections. The order, the suspension order last 6 months, how is this going to affect your bid for Congress, Governor Garcia?
Yes, I was asked that question, actually. I shall continue. I can still run for Congress in the 3rd District. And I think that question would probably be better answered by the people. I do know that the effect of what they have done to me here, or done to Cebu for that matter, has been very negative. First of all, and I'm not talking only of our supporters, but you know, the ordinary man on the street. We Cebuanos are used to the principles of fair play. Kung may laban, may labanan. Ano lang, yung patas lang yung laban.
Mm-hmm.
Huwag yung namang may mga dirty tactics there na the opponent's hands will be tied behind his or her back so that makabentaha yung sa kabila.
Mm-hmm.
And furthermore, you know, this suspension order coming as it does, so very near the Christmas season, does not fit well with the Cebuanos. Mm-hmm. We are a deeply religious people. And you know, the foremost in their mind is, did they have to do this during the Christmas season?
Mm.
In fact, even Archbishop Palma
yes.
has already spoken on the radio earlier, pointing out that this really does not fit very well with us. This is happening during the Christmas season.
Mm-hmm. Aren't you concerned, though, as a final question, Governor Garcia, aren't you concerned that the Cebuanos, the people dearest to you, will get caught in the crossfire here? Because here you are, a governor with a six-month suspension order, and you have an acting governor, duly appointed by the DILG, the Office of the President. Aren't you concerned that, you know, the acting governor might just come out with executive orders, but you still believe that you're still the chief executive of Cebu, and somewhere in the middle, sooner rather than later, the people of Cebu will get caught in the crossfire?
It is precisely because I do not want the people of Cebu to be caught in the crossfire. They recognize me as the governor of Cebu, Carmina. Even now, the mayors, the vice mayors, the barangay captains, they're coming here. They are pointing out that you are our duly recognized governor. If I were to turn my back on that responsibility, then it would be tantamount to turning my back on the very people who believe in me. And so I shall continue to serve. As I said naman, Carmina, you know, we are questioning this in court. We are taking all the legal action, remedies. So let's see for the next few days. Nakita naman dito, people are coming here to show their support, but this is a very peaceful gathering. And yung ano ko lang, yung hingi ko lang na wag naman na ano, we know that they have much political clout, pero wag naman na aabot to the point that they would show us physically just how powerful they are. Because our people have gathered here as it's their constitutional right to gather. And this is a very peaceful gathering. In fact, we just had a mass earlier. Let's just let the legal process continue.
And as you seek legal remedies regarding this particular issue, Governor Garcia, do you think that this decision coming from the office of the president will backfire on the palace?
If I were to answer that, that would be perhaps entirely coming from my point of view. But I think, Carmina, that could be best answered by the people themselves. I think media is a very good reader of public opinion. And by your asking me that question yourself, I think you have expressed a sentiment that is steadily growing.
All right, just asking questions here, Governor. In the meantime, we'd like to thank you for joining us tonight. Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia, we appreciate you talking to us on Primetime on ANC. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good night.